The therapeutic and side effects of opioids are largely mediated by their ability to bind and activate the so-called mu opioid receptors. Mu opioid receptors are localized in the spinal cord, mediate the analgesic effects, while mu opioid receptors localized in the brainstem, in an area called VTA, seem to be mainly responsible for the rewarding and euphoric effects. This is because the VTA is the localization of the cell bodies of neurons that synthesize dopamine, which is a key neurotransmitter in the processing of natural reward. We previously demonstrated that only in the VTA, mu opioid receptors form complexes with receptors for the neurotransmitter galanine. We call these complexes mu opioid galanine receptor heteromers. And now, by using artificial cell systems, we've been able to demonstrate that only in these complexes, mu opioid receptors acquire a specific properties such as selective insensitivity to methadone as compared to fentanyl or morphine. We then predicted that methadone would be a much weaker activator of the VTA dopamine system than fentanyl and morphine, which we've been able to demonstrate using two experimental rat models.
The results from the studies, the preclinical studies that Sergio just described, made a very powerful prediction that unlike other opioids like heroin or fentanyl, methadone would rarely be associated with euphoric effects or a feeling of a high. And so we had the unique opportunity to study the effects of different opioids in patients with addiction to opioids and patients with restless leg syndrome. And we were able to demonstrate that methadone was the only opioid that showed a clear dissociation of the therapeutic effects in terms of alleviation of opioid withdrawal symptoms or alleviation of restless leg symptoms versus euphoric symptoms. And so at therapeutic doses, methadone was associated with a significantly lower incidence of self-report of high as compared to other opioids. And our findings are really in accord with the now classic literature demonstrating that although opioid-addicted individuals use methadone illicitly, they do so not for the purpose of really trying to achieve a feeling of euphoria or high, but more for purposes of self-medication.
Well, the findings of the study are quite exciting as they may help diffuse some of the stigma attached to medication-based therapies for opioid use disorder. If it is indeed true that individuals taking methadone or not having rewarding effects from it, they will no longer be viewed as being addicted to another drug, which would decrease a major societal stigma and barrier to this life-saving treatment. I think that study will also stimulate further research into finding other medication-based therapies for opioid use disorder that are not rewarding, not rewarding to the individual, but will help prevent overdose and death.